All right, welcome back. Here it is. We got a little Stirling engine in. If you came over from the short, thanks. If not, click the link above and check out that short. We just kind of look at the box and show who was on it. It's actually a really nice box. Obviously, it came from China. So we'll open it up and we'll see exactly what we get in here. And they got different models, QRs that you can scan. So this is, looks like a parts box. Spare parts are in there, okay, that's cool. This is the steam engine part. I got some packing peanuts in here. So at least it's packed decently. This is the base. And I guess that's where you would put the fuel in. It's kind of strange. Hopefully it doesn't leak out, but I think we're gonna end up painting this anyways after it's assembled. So Star Power is the company. Here's a flywheel. It looks all right, it's not too bad. But again, we won't know until we put it all together. And here is the instructions, I guess. And this is a little, they give you a little pipette to fill up the fuel in there. And yep, these gotta be the instructions. All right, so we're gonna get everything opened up and laid out and see if we can build it. All right, there it is laid out. A whole bunch of pieces going on. They do include different Allen keys, so hopefully that's all we need to install this are just these Allens. And the first thing we gotta do is attach this to the base like that and get some screws in. All right, we got that attached to the base. And the next thing we gotta get in is the shaft and the two bearings. All right, we got the two little roller bearings in there with this shaft. Lubricated up with some 3-in-1 oil to make sure it spins and it's not in there dry. We gotta get this arm together and you're just gonna put that like that and drop this pin in it. The pin's not screwed in or anything, so hopefully it floats in there just fine. All right, that's what it looks like assembled. The pin kind of just free floats in there. We're gonna put a dot of oil and send it into this little cylinder here like that, because the flywheel is gonna go over here. All right, so we got it partially together here, and that's kind of how it's gonna spin in and out of there. There's just a little rubber O-ring that goes here and a Allen key that goes inside there. So we'll get those on. All right, if you see on there, all you're doing is putting a plastic white spacer behind that rod and in front of it, and then one of those clear cutoff spacers, and that assembles the flywheel side. This other side, we're gonna put the driving gear on there, and it's gonna be in the same fashion with a little Allen key, and it's probably gonna have the rod right there and everything. All right, we got that little side on. They did note that when the little screw there is at the 12 o'clock position, this pin will be at the 3 or the 9 o'clock position. So Allen had it at the 12, this must be in the 3 or 9 o'clock position. If it's not, it says to contact them, something might be wrong. But this looks good and it's spinning well. So we'll continue on. The next thing, we have to get this rod going through here now, connecting over here. All right, we got this thing together here. We're supposed to put one spacer on each side on the inside, not on the outside, so correction on that. And then just put two spacers there. We lubed everything up on this side and out here, but this, you'll need to lube with graphite powder because that's actually the hot chamber. So don't put any liquid lubricant in here, you might mess it up. But it's actually running very smoothly for a cheap little kit from overseas. The seventh instruction legitimately says have a rest. So we're gonna do that, we're gonna take a break. All right, we're back after that short break. The next thing we wanna do is get the diffuser piston in there. Go ahead and slide it over this rod and seat it all the way down. Put an Allen key in, or Allen head screw in there, the last one in the kit. All right, we got the displacer piston in there. Everything is sliding good. The next thing you wanna do is take the glass, or in this case, this is steel, which we like because they do sell a lot of them with the glass tubes and those could break. Slide an O-ring on there and then put this right over on here And we're going to take this plate here, take this blue protective coating off, and this plate is going to sandwich that displacer cover on there and keep a good seal. All right, that's basically it. This thing is assembled. It did come with this weird little tool here. Not sure what it was, but we used it to, it actually fit over the shaft to space the flywheel and the little driven gear here away from the casting. So it does feel really smooth now. That could be an issue with some people building these things. But now we have to get the fuel source in there, and it comes with this little syringe, but it says in there, you can fill it one of two ways, through this little tiny hole that stays open all the time, or removing that cap and then using the syringe to put some alcohol in there. You really want a high content alcohol in there that doesn't leave soot. So we're gonna get this thing set in there and show you how we do it. Basically just push that down in there and we bring a little bit of the wick up. Take it and wrap one end around this screw hole in here, because that's the only way you're gonna get this thing to really close properly, because they give you a lot of wick. And then you kind of just want to set it on there. So we're gonna get this thing filled up with some denatured alcohol and we'll see if it runs. We're going to light it for the first time and see what happens. We've never used one of these before, so hopefully it doesn't blow up. I think that's lit. Yep, it looks lit. I have no idea how this actually works. But the fire is lit, you see it. Hopefully it doesn't cause a fire everywhere. So you can't fill it too much. Definitely can't overfill it. Alright. Looks like it's starting to go. Let's give it a second to heat up still. It's starting to pick up, we can feel it. So hopefully with the displacement, and again, you wanna use really clean alcohol. This is denatured alcohol, 100 proof or better to keep the soot out, especially if you're gonna run it indoors. Oh, it's starting. Yeah, just a little bit more heat. This is the first time it's getting run, so things are a little tight. Not gonna work the other way. Oh, it's starting to start up. And there it goes. I think it's gonna run. Ah, almost. We'll see, it's still heating up. It wants to go. Might take a little tweaking, little adjustments, but we'll see what happens here. All right, there it goes. It's running. Hopefully it stays running. We'll see if it picks up speed or not. Thank you. So it is running. We can see the flame is a little offset. We'll adjust it. Maybe get some more speed out of it. There it goes. It's running very smooth now. Nice and quiet. Does get a little warm, so be aware of that. Get that flame over the whole thing. Not a super powerful engine, but it is moving. Put a little graphite in there, maybe it'll move better. Super, super quiet though. We're just gonna let it run for a while and see if we can get it to improve a little bit. We decided to put it up on the box. Don't recommend doing this while it's running because that is a flame that is active right there, but we wanted to show you how smooth and quiet this is. If you take time and build it the way it's supposed to be built. Extremely quiet, running just off of alcohol. And it's been going for quite some time now. So we'll let it keep going and see how long it stays running for, and we'll update you. All right, it is starting to slow down here. So roughly about 10 minutes of runtime you get out of this little thing. So not bad. I mean, toy's about 40 bucks. It's educational, it's a steam engine. It's all metal, so it seems like it's gonna last a while. It's smooth, extremely, extremely smooth. Probably end up putting some little rubber pegs or feet on the bottom there. And like we said, we'll probably end up painting this. But yeah, it's running excellent. What a great little toy. So thanks for tuning in. If you like this content, smash the like button, comment, share, and subscribe. See you in the next video. Later.